Hi guys, welcome or welcome back. Thanks so much for joining me. Today we're going to do an eye edit in Photoshop to make those eyes pop. Welcome or welcome back. If you're new here, then hi, I'm Jess. I'm a portrait photographer and I photograph all sorts of stuff, but mainly dogs. That's what you guys mostly know me for. Please do consider hitting the subscribe button and hitting that bell icon. The bell icon will help you out because it'll give you a notification every single time I upload a video. I upload every single Friday with some form of tip, trick, or other related content. So it would be great to have you with us if you could. I covered off in the monthly challenge review video way back at the start of December, which feels like ages ago, that I would put a video up onto the channel of our eye edit that we've been doing for years and years and years. So this eye edit is something that we have taught out in private one-to-ones, in online courses, and all sorts of other different places. So I'm just going to go through it step by step as its own standalone video to make sure that you guys have got it to hand. So first things first, you're going to need to be in Photoshop or a similar program. You can pick whatever you want. I would recommend going ahead and watching our Photoshop basics video because we're going to discuss layer masks, we're going to discuss layers, we're going to discuss adjustment layers as well. If Photoshop is terrifying for you, go ahead and maybe look at the Photoshop for Beginners online course, which is over on our website. I'll put a link to that above so that you can go and have a look at that if Photoshop is scary for you. But with that all said and done, we're going to switch over and look at this image. So this is a photograph of Bright. You guys all know Bright, and she's looking super adorable in this autumnal, kind of golden hour, kind of not. It was just before golden hour, if we're being honest. And she's got these gorgeous little eyes anyway, but they are quite dark, right? Because she's got quite dark eyes. These look quite light for Bright, to be honest, because usually they're basically black. But at this stage, if I was just to kind of finish this image now, we would be missing out on the opportunity to add additional impact. And so this is why we're going to use this image to do an eye edit. So it's actually really not had a lot done to it at all. We've cleaned up some eye bogeys and stuff. But what we're going to do is add a curves adjustment layer. So down here, you have the adjustment layer icon. We're going to go ahead and click on that and add a curves adjustment layer. So when you've got the curves adjustment layer open, if you go ahead and look at your properties tab, if you don't have properties, don't panic. If you need to be able to see properties, you can go ahead and go up to window and choose properties. But if you want your Photoshop to match my workspace, then there is a video on that, so I'll link that above in terms of setting up your workspace in Photoshop to match mine. So with the properties tab open, you can see the curves. We've done a video on curves. I'll link that above as well because curves is super versatile. But what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and add a pin right in the middle of that curve there and then lift it all the way up to the top here. So a good way of looking at this is if you see you've got three vertical lines coming up the curve, right? So we've got 1, 2, and 3. You want this pin to be pretty much sat at the top of the first vertical line in from the left, right? So your curve should look like this, and it looks kind of terrifying in terms of looking at the image, but don't panic. What we're then gonna do is grab our mask, and at the moment it's white. If you remember from Photoshop Basics, white means that that is applied everywhere. I want it to apply nowhere. So I need to change white to the opposite, which is black. And to do that, I'm gonna just use my keyboard shortcuts and choose Command I, which is invert. If you want a Windows, don't panic. Command exchange it for Control. So we've got a black layer mask happening at the moment. So that adjustment is now not applying anywhere at all. So at this stage, what I want to do is go ahead and grab a brush. And my brush is going to be set to white because I want to break through this black mask and show what's underneath. So I need it to be white. And then I'm going to make sure that my opacity of the brush is all the way up to 100 and the flow is also all the way up to 100. We need to make sure that we're using the soft round brush for this particular operation. So make sure that you're on soft round there. And then I personally use my keyboard shortcuts. There is a video on that, but I'm pretty sure I definitely will have run over my allowed link amounts. So I'll put it in the description below. So keyboard shortcuts to change the brush size on a Mac are Command and Option, and then click and pull right for bigger, left for smaller, up for softer, and down for harder. So we want super soft, and we want the actual size of this brush to be about the same size as the dog's eye, okay? So, or the subject's eye, it doesn't have to be just a dog. So we're going for about that size, realistically. And then what you want to do, and it's very specific here, you want to line up the center of your brush circle with the lower lid line, okay? So we're imagining that there is a pin in the middle of that. We're going to put it in the middle of that brush at the lower lid line. And then we're going to click once at the bottom of the eye. The same with the other eye, so lower lid line, and we're going to click once. So that's essentially giving us a soft transfer from the strongest application of that curves adjustment to nothing as it moves out. But what it also does, which we don't want, is it gives us this spill over onto the lower lid. So what we're going to go ahead and do with our brush is switch our palette. So I'm going to just press X to switch to black. And then what I want to do is harden up the brush to about 50%-ish. And then with that, I'm going to go ahead and just brush carefully around the lower lid line. So what I'm doing here is I'm taking that effect off of the lower lid line, the lower whites, if we can see that, and potentially just the edge of the iris. And then again, we're going to just duplicate the effect we're doing and match it to the other side. So just giving it a dust off. Maybe went in a little bit far on that one, but just make sure that they're even, okay? So with that done, we then need to go ahead and take it off of one other place, and that's the pupil, because the pupil should be really deep and dark. So what I do is I make my brush size about the size of the iris, right? So it's about the size of the iris, the colored area of the eye. And then I want it to be about 25% hardness. And this time I'm gonna line my brush up with the center of the pupil, sometimes slightly higher than that, depends on how the dog is looking. And then we're gonna click twice to just break through at the pupil. So we're gonna do one and two, and we're still on 100% opacity, so nothing's changed there. Now at this point, we then go and look really specifically at catch lights. So in the eyes, you should have, ideally, catch lights in both eyes. So these catch lights are the reflections of whatever else is happening. And we wanna go ahead and address these. So we want a small brush that matches the size of most of the catch lights. And we also want it to be as hard as the catch lights in the eyes, right? And then I'm gonna want to apply this curves adjustment, so I need to be breaking through the mask with a white brush. And I'm gonna go ahead now and just draw as specifically as you can, but I mean, come on, I don't have all day, over the catch lights in the eyes, right? So you just basically painting along and drawing in the catch lights in the eyes. You can, if you want to, use quite a sweeping brush. It really depends on the catch lights. I was in a woodland location here, so it suits having a smaller brush, because then I can go around all of the trees that are naturally occurring in the eye. Da 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 da. Okay, so when you're done with doing your catch lights, you should be in a situation where your dog looks semi-radioactive, right? This looks like the dog's possessed and the eyes are at this stage over-edited, they're over-processed. The reason why we put it on so strong is so that we can clearly see what we're doing and where it's applying. But then at this stage, when you're happy with your application, then you go ahead to the opacity of the layer itself and bring that down to usually below 50%. It depends on the dog. I usually like around 30%, but that's me personally. You can do what you want. In this instance, let's go ahead and put it at 40, and I'll try not to feel that that's too much. So now we're looking at this image. It looks like the dog's got beautiful, bright eyes. It doesn't look over-processed. It doesn't look over-colored. But look how it did look without. So that's before and that's after. Before and after. So it makes a really big difference to how the image looks because those eyes connect with the viewer straight away. It adds impact, and if you're careful with your brush strokes, it will make the world of difference to your images. So that is how you do our that photography spot eye edit in terms of the curves adjustments. There are so many other ways to do eye edits. Now I use a bit of a different way, but this method is a really good one to start with to get you comfortable flicking between your palettes, using your brushes, using your masks, and using your adjustment layers. So that is our curves adjustment layer for eyes. Hope this video was useful for you. If it was, please do let us know down below in the comment section. Give this video a thumbs up and as always subscribe because that would be great, and I'll see you all again really, really soon.